A very good morning to all. Warm greetings from your social studies teacher. Children, today we are going to start Civics Chapter 2, Diversity, Prejudice and Discrimination. The chapter is divided into further subheadings: Prejudice and Stereotype, Prejudice and Discrimination, Inequality and Discrimination, The Constitution and Respect for Diversity, and Fundamental Rights and Directive Principles of State Policy. Let's first of all understand, what do you understand by diversity? India is a land of differences in terms of language, culture, religion, tradition and so on. In India, people speak different languages, follow different religion, they have different tradition, they have different dressing sense in different parts of the country. And all these differences altogether make India a diverse country. Now let's discuss what is prejudice. It is an important term of our chapter. Children, prejudice means negative feeling or biased opinion about someone. As I told you that India is a diverse country. Here people speak different languages, they have different faiths, they have different religion, tradition. So generally what happens, we prefer to like people who think like us, who look like us, whose dress, food habits, customs, religions match with us. And we become unfamiliar and we start thinking people strange, whose habits, whose customs, traditions are different from us. In fact, we start calling them as strangers and we create negative opinion about them. So this is prejudice. Prejudice means negative feeling or biased opinion about someone. Let's understand it through an example. Suppose there come a new child in your school. The child comes from a rural background, that's why her dressing sense is different from you. The child speaks in rural way. Her accent is rural. And because of all these things, that child dresses differently, speaks in a rural accent, you start thinking that child is inferior and you are superior, and then you start teasing the child. You create negative feeling about that child. A biased opinion that the child is inferior from you. Okay, so what happens? This prejudice has created negative atmosphere. It has created bad relationship between you and that child. Okay, let's move toward what is stereotype. Children, this is only that prejudice which results in the development of stereotype. Stereotype means a fixed notion about someone or something. In stereotype, we tend to generalize and fit people or groups in a particular image. And this image may be created on the basis of particular region, religion, race, gender, or economic background. So, all these notions like prejudice and stereotypes, which creates a fixed notion about someone, a negative attitude towards someone, they results in bad relationships, in unhealthy understanding about relationships. Now let's discuss what is discrimination. Children, when we have prejudice and stereotypical notions about somebody or something, then we start behaving in rude manner toward that person, and then takes place discrimination. As discrimination is unfair treatment of a person or a group of person on the basis of prejudice or stereotype. Let's discuss now what is inequality and discrimination. So this is also due to prejudice and stereotype. the negative opinion and the fixed image about someone starts creating deep distinctions based on caste, gender, economic status, language, and so on. And it results in the discrimination of some group of people by those who are in powerful position, who are rich, who are well educated, who are well settled. This also leads to a certain attitude, opinion, and behavior. And we start denying the right to equality to those people who are discriminated. And thus, we start violating in some ways the principles of democracy, where all human beings are considered equal. All are given equal rights. This prejudice and discrimination, which gives birth to inequality and discrimination, it also hinder the progress of the backward class, their interest, because they are being discriminated. Those who are rich, who are well educated, they do not like to give them power. They do not like to give them the rights to get equal education like them, to get equal health facilities like them. Children, inequality is different from diversity, because diversity is created due to geographical and historical factors. As I told you, diversity means, like in India, people speak different languages, they have different traditions, they have different customs, their dressing sense is different. So this depends upon geographical factors. Like we, the people of Haryana, are different from the people of South India. But children, inequality stems from man-made social and economic factors. Now let's see, what are these man-made social and economic factors? See, number one, inequality is created by caste system. Children, in ancient time, in the past time, Indian society was a graded society. We had class system. We had lower class like Shudra, then Vaishya, then Kshatriya, then Brahmin. And these higher classes had a certain, they had thinking that these lower classes are inferior to them. And what happened with the passage of time, the lower caste became a victim of discrimination by the upper caste. The upper caste started to violate the rights of lower caste. They also called them untouchables, achhoot, or Dalits. And especially those who were expected to perform menial tasks, means the persons who were engaged in activities like in sweeping, in cleaning, they had to face rigid restrictions. Like they were not allowed to enter temples, they were not allowed to send their children in the schools to get education like the children of higher class people. Second, we have inequality created by unequal distribution of wealth. Children, due to this inequality and due to this caste system, as some people are in higher caste and some people are in lower caste, it gives birth to unequal distribution of wealth also. Poor people become more poor and rich people become more rich. And then what happens? The poor people, they are subjected to all kind of restrictions and hardships and difficulties. As I told you earlier, they are deprived of education. They are not allowed to get education. They are not allowed to get best health facilities. And also they lack the money. They lack the sources to purchase all these kind of services for them. Third is inequality created by racial differences. Children, it's very easy to understand racial discriminated in the past time when India was under colonial rule of Britisher. When there was British rule in India, I mean to say, when there was British rule in India, at that time, the non-whites, means we, the Indians, were considered inferior. We were ill-treated. We were treated in a bad manner. We were held in contempt. We were hated by the people of white class, means the Britishers, because of especially the color of the skin, because they were white and we were black. So we were considered inferior to those white people. And in South Africa, this term, this racial segregation term, is given a particular name, which is called apartheid. This apartheid term is used in South Africa, okay, for racial segregation. You will see this in your chapter, in this point. And third, inequality and discrimination was done on the basis of gender. It's very easy to understand, children. You must have observed somewhere and somehow that girls are considered inferior to boys. Women are considered inferior to men. It is said that women do not need education because they don't have to do anything. They have to do only household chores. They have to take care of the family. They have, and that's why they are neglected of their of the other things, like they are not given proper education. They are not given the facilities, the respect, the kind of regard which is given to male members of the family, as male members are considered as the head of the family. So it is generally believed that all decision will be taken by the male members of the family, and women are considered as the subjugated part of the family. Baba Saheb Bhim Rao Ambedkar, he was the chief architect of Indian Constitution. Children, he was also a part of poor Mahar family. In his childhood, he faced all kind of hardships and social disabilities. But he was a strong person. He grew up to be a jurist, a political leader, a thinker, an anthropologist. An anthropologist is a person who studies human behavior and society. And he fought against all these discrimination and inequalities which was done against the Dalits and untouchables. Now let's see the constitution and respect for diversity. What does our constitution speak about the diversity? See, our constitution teaches us to respect our diversity. Our constitution guides us that we should love our diversity, that it is because of this feature our India is given a unique national identity. Our culture is considered a rich culture. We have different religion, different regions, different languages, different traditions, different dressing sense. All these things make Indian culture a rich culture. The Constitution of India guarantees equal rights, opportunities to everyone, no matter they belong to what caste, what creed, religion or gender. The Constitution of India considers untouchability, that chhuachhoot, as a crime, and it has been legally abolished by law. So, in the eye of our Constitution, all people are equal, they have equal rights. Fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy. The fundamental rights of our constitution uphold the principles of equality and freedom. Any person who is denied his right can go to court of law to fight for his rights. The Constitution also directs the government to make policies and adopt certain measures which will bring about social and economic reform and equality. Like, let's discuss what reforms are provided by fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy. Number one, it says that there should be a fair distribution of wealth. Second, there is a free and compulsory education till the age of 14. There is equal pay for equal work. And there are suitable arrangements and law to safeguard the interest of old and sick people. Then there are enactments to uplift the discriminated sections of our society which have suffered from certain disabilities, from certain restrictions and rigidities. Next is introduction of effective schemes to remove poverty from rural and urban areas. And next is, it has guided that we should empower our women through education and they should be protected legally also. I think the chapter is clear to you children. Now I will give you one more video regarding the assignment of your book, of your book work. So we will discuss that part in another video. Listen to this video carefully. I believe this will help you. Thank you.